I was in a microbiology program at first. I was headed to medical school like my mom. And then I discovered philosophy, and something about it just stuck. I think everybody has that moment when you find what you're supposed to do, where it's just, I cannot believe that I didn't know about this from day one. So philosophy was always in the back of my mind. I double majored in it at first. I was still on the science track, but it was always there. Something was always keeping me there. And then the more I went through my undergraduate program, it just became very clear to me that philosophy, like I said, it's not just a program of study. It's not just a degree that you get. It's actually something that you live. And that has just become a very important focus, which is something that I feel is embraced at DSBT also.
I am a big believer in the journey, and I've always been a seeker, whether it's a seeker of truth, a seeker of art, a seeker of beauty. Ultimately, for me, it's a seeker of beauty, because God is beauty. I was able to do it and balance my home life and school life at the same time. I really have to say that Dominican School of Philosophy and Theology, their flexibility is gracious and generous, and for a later in life student coming back, not without nervous moments, what's going to happen, it's always had a good outcome.
I'm having the time of my life here studying these authors, being able to ask these questions, and I really appreciate being in a place where the questions are taken very seriously and they're not taken merely for their historical interest. The professors here and the students here are asking these questions in earnest.
Theology, I think, is a degree that's overlooked a lot in the world because it really isn't something that you're gonna be like, I'm gonna get a degree in theology and make a lot of money and be very successful. It's definitely more of a personal journey. I think a really unique part of the DSPT is the concentration in art program, because it really allows students to get to know their faith and learn about their faith in a very tangible way. I just feel like the professors here really want me to flourish as a unique child of God.
A formal study of philosophy combined with the formal study of theology and at the service of theology is capable of making us much more able to relate not just to an academic community of other people who have studied the things we study, or even an academic community of people who haven't studied the things we study, but even to your average person who is just trying to think about why something makes them happy or why something bothers them. And when we are able to reach to people in that sense, we actually epitomize, I think, the Dominican tradition of preaching as the purpose of our life.
I'm actually an architect by trade, and I was very interested in understanding the relationship between the spaces that we encounter and our experience of the sacred in those spaces. They have a wonderful program in arts and religion. There's no comparison in Australia, so I actually had to come out of Australia, travel overseas to get a course where I could follow this passion that was so deep seated in my heart that I ended up here, living back in Australia now, but so thankful and grateful for what I experienced and what I learned here. So, great place, wonderful place.
We were founded by Saint Dominic with the express charism of preaching the gospel wherever and however it needs to be preached. It requires the type of education which, A, is rooted in the tradition, of course exemplified by St. Thomas Aquinas, but also cannot have any fear or trepidation with regards to engaging the modern world, engaging the world as it is right now, where we see the world, where are people, where is culture. This is essential for the vocation of a preacher. This is essential for Dominican education specifically as being the order of preachers. That's exactly what the Dominican School of Philosophy and Theology provides.